If your team uses any of the Software Planner suite of products, including ALM Complete, Dev Complete, or QA Complete, with the on-premises edition, formerly called the Enterprise Edition, you have some additional capabilities that allow you to secure things using Active Directory. By utilizing the Active Directory authentication, it simplifies the password management for your team. With this Active Directory authentication, it allows your team to authenticate Software Planner login passwords using the Active Directory password that you previously set up. It also allows Software Planner accounts to be automatically set up if a new user is added to Active Directory but not yet set up in Software Planner. Finally, it also allows users that have been disabled from Active Directory to automatically be disabled from Software Planner. So if one of your team members leaves your company and you disable them from Active Directory, it'll automatically disable them from Software Planner. Before your team can use the Active Directory configuration, you'll first need to give security authority to the right group of people to allow them to set this preference up. To do that, go into the Setup area, then go into Security, and then go into Security Groups. If your security administrators are the one that normally set up the preferences for the application, that might be a good set of people to give that right to. And to do that, you simply go to the Security Group, press on the Manage Security Rights area, and then it'll take you to a list of rights. If you scroll down to the bottom of the list of rights, one of the items that you're going to see here is called Manage Active Directory Authentication. As long as this group of people have that access, then you'll be able to manage that Active Directory authentication directly here from the product. To get to that area, once that's checked, go to System Configuration, then Active Directory Authentication. Once here, you'll put in your LDAP connection URL in this field. You'll also put in your domain and your domain controller right here in the user base area. The lookup username is the Active Directory name that you would like for it to use when it looks up the information about a user as they log in. And then the password for the user lookup would be your Active Directory password that has the credentials to be able to look up user accounts during login process. The query attribute allows you to specify how you would like those user accounts to be looked up. For example, within the Software Planner line of products, all of the user accounts are set up by email address. The query attribute here can be set up for account name, so if you don't carry the email address inside of Active Directory, then you can use, for example, an account name. If you prefer to use email, you can use email in this area. Once you've defined your LDAP connection information, you can also test your LDAP authentication by simply typing in your email address, password, and your Active Directory account user lookup value here, and then it will query your Active Directory to ensure that the connection is valid. The last part of the setup area allows you to tailor how Software Planner Active Directory options will work. For example, log each Active Directory password authentication. This option allows you to post all of the authentication events to an audit file. This is great for troubleshooting any Active Directory authentication or configuration issues. The next area says, at login, automatically create a new Software Planner account if successfully authenticated in Active Directory. You'll want to check this box if you want your Active Directory users to automatically set up in Software Planner without any intervention from you. You must be using an email address as the query attribute for this particular process to work. The next four fields on the screen are the default settings for Software Planner users created from Active Directory authentication, which occurs when this is checked. For example, what project do you want those new users to be added to automatically? All projects or a specific project? When the new users are added to the security group, which security group should they be added to? You can choose that here. You can also choose a default time zone for any new users that are added. So if most of your people are here in, let's say, the eastern part of the United States, you might want to choose GMT-5. Finally, if you'd wanted to send an email to one or more people once a new user was added automatically, you can type in your email address here and it'll send the appropriate email when someone new is added. Next, you'll see an area here where you can actually specify that a new user was set up. For example, This is the email body that would be sent to the person in this send notification email to. So if you wanted to have the email say that a new Active Directory user has been added to Software Planner, that's what the email will say once you receive that email. The final option here says at logon, if the user cannot be found in Active Directory, do you want to disable that Software Planner user account? This is a good option because if you have set it up so that maybe a person from your team leaves your company and you disable them in Active Directory, this particular item here will prevent them from logging into Software Planner because it'll automatically disable that account once it figures out that the Active Directory account has been disabled. Once your Active Directory is set up and you've tested the authentication, the next thing that you'll want to do is begin setting up users within Software Planner. To do that, you simply go to the Users area, and if you'd like to add a new user, you can press Add New. Once here, fill in all of the details. The information that's related to the Active Directory is down here, Active Directory User. If you check that as the person logs in, rather than confirming the password that's stored here inside of ALM Complete, it will verify against the Active Directory password. Once this is set up as an Active Directory user, you'll also need to specify here what the Active Directory account setup is. For example, if you're doing it by Active Directory name, then it might be the last name, comma, first name. If you're doing the lookup by email address, then it might be an email address. Okay. So as you can see here, you can have some users within Software Planner use Active Directory for their security needs, while others don't use Active Directory. So it gives you a lot of flexibility in how you can use this. This concludes the topic of Active Directory authentication. We hope you enjoyed this feature.